Okay, here we go, crashing wings. It's another grab from the behind. What we're doing? Why is a person coming behind us again? Let's go over it. Why? We always want to go over and visualize in our minds and do the situation. The rear attack, the person's doing it probably because of one reason. We know them. We know who they are and they don't want to be recognized. If it's not, it's somebody that definitely doesn't want to be recognized so where you can identify them. With this technique, we're going to step out. Just like the cup of water, we duplicate a whole lot. If the thing works, don't fix it. Keep applying it in different situations. If the cup is full, it works, just like you're standing there. Person grabs us, our arms are free. We're going to step out, just like pouring out the cup of water. The cup of water, when it was contained, was easy to manage. When it's spilled out, it's all over the place. It takes longer. By widening up my base, I've exposed my targets. From here, I'm going to come in with two inward overhead elbow strikes. This is the most powerful strike we have in the upper body. You have the marriage of force coming down and gravity pulling it. And you're striking with your elbow. What are you striking? On their forearms. You want to give them some pain. Striking on their forearms, settling down on their base, is going to put pressure on their lower back. And this is just the starts. From here, we slide behind. Put our knee in nice and tight. Let them sit down. Enjoy. Give them the best seat in the house. After all, they're your guest. Elbow their face, follow with a forearm. Our hammer fist, just continue it through. Striking to the groin. Is there a takedown? Sure. Let them lay down. They look like they need a rest after that. Standing here, person attacks you from behind. What a coward. Why doesn't this person face you head on? We've established it. Step out. Strike. Go behind. Plant. Set up. Elbow. Hammer. Finish the strike. Let them fall. There they are. Let's bring Diane out now, and we'll show you how this works. As Diane comes up behind me, I'm going to step out. By widening up my base, she can't pick me up now. I just spilt that cup of water. Striking to her forearms right here. I've given her a little bit of pain. What's body respond to? Pain or pleasure. This is the pleasure I have by giving her pain. Stepping behind, locking the leg. Striking to the face, hammer fist to the face. Finishing any strike that I want in any one of these areas. When I'm through, just step out. Let the chips fall where they are. She's going to have more damage happen to her now just by hitting the ground. Force is on your side. That's gravity. Learn how to use it. Let's go. Coming up behind me. Grab me. I go out. Strike. Come behind. Elbow. Hammer. Strike. Pull it out. We're not sure what damage is going to be done to her on the ground because of one reason. We didn't imply it. The imply comes across the fact she's the one that has to deal with the situation. If her force goes down, she doesn't know how to fall, too bad. But she grabbed us. This is our self-defense. This is her form of attacking a person. Let's look at it again. Out. Strike. Come behind. Elbow. Hammer. Drop. Let's look at it full speed. As Diane comes up, we don't wait for her to get comfortable. We wait for the feel. Once we feel it, we snap into action. Pull it out. Set it up. There you have it. She's on the ground. We have to see what's happening. Understand the anatomy, you know how to apply self-defense. Understand the anatomy too, you need to know it very, very, it's critical. Why? What you do to this body, you're going to be the first one there to administer first aid. You got to help him. You want to learn how to protect life, not take it. Pull it out.